Welcome, everyone. Brad Nessler here for EA Sports with my co-host Kirk Herbstreit and the coach, Lee Corso. And we've got rainy conditions here for tonight's game between the Northern Illinois Huskies and the Northwestern Wildcats. We're ready to bring you what should be one intense football game. And here come the Wildcats. The Wildcats seem to have the better team. They should win this game. What do you think, Kirk?
Northwestern needs to look no further than their quarterback to figure out what holds his team together. His ability to read the defense and take what they give him is the reason they'll win this football game. He's a smart young man.
I like it, Kirk. That's an excellent pick.
I'm picking the Wildcats in this one.
Looks like they're ready for the kick. We should have a return on this one. Number 29 fields it at the 3. They'll go to work at the 25. They come out with four wide out. Counterplay. Gets past the tackler. And down he goes. And that was an excellent run there.
Yeah, Brad, but it was also great blocking up front by the offensive line to open up the hole.
It's first and 10. Ball on their own 42. Northwestern comes out in the shotgun. They'll throw on first down. He'll dump this one off. Incomplete.
Drop pass. That'll drive the coach crazy. That'll drive the quarterback crazy. And that'll drive the fans crazy.
Well, I'm sure he'll get an earful when he gets to the sideline.
You bet he will.
So it's second and 10. Ball on the 42-yard line. Number 14 has five receivers lined up here. Drops back to pass. He's looking. He's going right. Inside the 30. And they bring him down.
Wow. Nice catch.
Way to look it in. Heck of a job by the wide receiver. These guys are moving the ball down the field.
First and 10. We'll see what they can do in the red zone. Northwestern goes with the ace set here. They'll throw on first down. Looks. Wants to throw outside. In and out of his hand. Dropped by the wideout. The Wildcats with four receivers. Here's an opening. They'll bring him down. An 8-yard gain. Northwestern will line up in a jumbo set here. And they'll try to get the first through the air. Looking, throws this one out to the left. And it falls incomplete. The pass was right there. Just couldn't be controlled.
Just tied in some more passes in practice. He needs all the help he can get.
Number 14 lines up in the shotgun. Throw. Touchdown, Northwestern. The big tight end makes a play and finds the end zone.
Yo, that looks like a freight train of stick-em out there.
And he hits the PAT. Fine folks at Pontiac bringing us this summary of how that drive took place. Looks like they're ready for the kick. Kicks it deep. Number 24 fields it in the end zone. A little shake and bake move. So before the offense hits the field, let's take the time to let you know that our game is brought to you by EA Sports. It could be a long day for this right tackle as he takes on the challenge of blocking this animal at defensive end.
We're going to have the opportunity to see a guy who can really create problems by getting to the quarterback.
And something tells me he's going to be getting to the quarterback a lot today. He's not exactly going against the best right tackle in the world.
It's second down now, 14 to go. Ball on the 14. Huff, back in the gun, steps up, throws this one out to the right. Tackle, 6 yard pickup.
Makes the reception, gain of 6 on the play.
Third and 8, ball on their own 20. Northern Illinois lines up with 3 receivers. Huff drops back to pass, short toss, and it's caught. And they make the stop. A nice completion that time.
Good completion. And I don't know if you guys noticed or not, but that was exactly the same play they just ran. They're not very creative in their play calling.
Creative? You don't need to be creative with these kind of results.
The Huskies come out in the ace formation. They keep it on the ground with the tailback. And he's taken down, a 7-yard run by the running back.
7-yard gain on the play.
Second and 3 coming up, and this is the 5th play of the current drive. The Huskies come out in the ace formation. The Huskies come out in the ace formation. Here's the option. He's into the open field. And down he goes. This one might be coming back, folks. Let's check out the penalty.
Personal foul, face mask on the defense. 15 yards from the spot of the foul.
He's going to get a 15-yard penalty there for grabbing his face mask.
He grabbed it and he held on. He should know he's got to let go.
It's first and 10, ball on the 33. The Huskies come out showing 3 wide. A little juke. Brought down. Maybe a yard on that draw play.
1 yard gain on the play.
Second and 9. And this is the 7th play of the current drive. The Huskies come out in the ace formation. He'll give it off here,
and he's hit hard.
1, 2, 3, Kirk, he might be out for the count.
Oh, what a hit. You know, at the end of the year, you're going to look back at this and remember this is one of the hits of the year. That guy can really bring it.
So another 3rd down upcoming for the offense. Huff lines up in the shotgun. He drops back. He steps up. He has some room. Sheds that one. With a spin, tackle. He had a whole lot of room to run on that one.
When the pressure's coming from the inside and the quarterback can escape the pocket, it usually means he's going to have some room to run.
It's first and 10. They're in the red zone. The Huskies with four receivers. Nickel defense. Huff on the opposite. Ball's loose. Offense falls on it. And he's hit hard. Are you kidding me? They recover the fumble. But man, oh man, was that a close call.
That's about as ugly as an option can look.
Well, it certainly wasn't pretty, that's for sure. But like Brad said, they recovered the football. It's part of the past now, so they just need to forget about it and focus on their next play.
Second down, and they got 15 for the first down. Ball on the 18. Three wideouts here. Huff set to go to the air. Wants to throw outside, and it's the senior. They'll bring him down. They'll grab 10 yards there.
Gain of 10 on the play.
After a quarter of play, our score is Northwestern 7, Northern Illinois nothing. Huff is back in the gun. Stopped behind the line, and they snuffed out the quarterback draw there.
Yep, there was absolutely nowhere for the quarterback to run on that play. Good job by this defense.
Number 25 is lined up for the kick. It's up, and it sails right on him. No good. Start this drive at the 20. Number 14 lines up in the shotgun. He's looking. Throws it deep downfield. It falls incomplete. He had his wide out, but he couldn't hit him.
When he misses, it's usually high, and that's something he's been working very hard with his coach on.
So it's second and 10. Ball on the 20-yard line. The Wildcats come out in the ace formation.
Hut. Hut.
They go with a toss. He just brought down. 3-yard gain by the running back.
3-yard gain on the play.
It's third down and 7 to go. Ball on the 23-yard line. Number 14. There's 5 receivers lined up here. Across the middle. Got him on the run, and down he goes. First and 10, ball on their own 37. The Wildcats set up in the gun. Throw on first down. Looks. Throws down the middle. Got it to him on the run.
I like the defense that was called. They just didn't make the play on the ball.
You're right. It wasn't necessarily bad defense. The offense just executed, and the result is a first down.
It's first and 10. This is the fifth play of this drive. Number 14 lines up in the shotgun. Back to pass. Looking. Across the middle. Got him on the run. Tackle.
Nice decision by the quarterback.
Not only was it good decision-making, but the offensive line protected just long enough for him to find his target.
And when you combine the two, it'll be a first down 9 out of 10 times.
Have a look at our Old Spice Red Zone numbers. Red Zone, when performance matters the most. They come out with four wide out. They keep it on the ground with the tailback. And they make the stop. Picked up a yard of anything on that run.
1 yard gain on the play.
It's second down and 9 to go. And this is the 7th play of the current drive. From the gun. Across the middle. The ball is tipped.
Excellent job of getting a hand in there to break up the pass.
It was, Coach. That one had reception written all over it, but the defender stepped up and made the play.
So another third down upcoming for the offense. The Wildcat come out in the shotgun, steps up in the pocket. Across the middle, brought down. On third and long, they get the first down, but was it close?
Close or not, what a relief it is to the quarterback to have a new set of downs to work with.
The Wildcat come out in the ace formation, drops back to pass, steps up, he's looking, fires, touchdown, Northwestern. That was a well-drawn-up play for the wideout.
Yeah, they saw something upstairs. It led to a touchdown. You can thank the play calling here. Very impressive.
And he tacks on the extra point. Here's the Pontiac drive summary, bringing you fuel for the soul. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff.
Number 24, Max needs to return.
He kicks it. Number 24 fields it in the end zone. Their kicker missed the field goal attempt the last time this offense had it. Let's see what happens this time around.
Yeah, that poor kicker has to wait on the sideline and hopes he gets a chance to redeem himself after that last miss.
Watch the linebacker. He's the star of the defense, and he's in the zone right now. On the ground with the tailback. And he's hit hard. The running back gets two on the carry. It's second down and 8 to go. Ball on the 20-yard line. Huff with three wide receivers. They'll go with the run once again. And he's tackled. 3 yard gain by the running back.
3 yard gain on the play.
Third and 5. Ball on the 23-yard line. Northern Illinois in a 4-wide set. He drops back, rolls right, looks, throws back across field. Complete, tackle, Northwestern calls a timeout. Northern Illinois lining up the punt, he gets it off. Number 28 fields it at the 34. Passing wasn't much of a problem the last time this offense had the ball, as they were able to get it in for six. They'll set up shot at the 36-yard line. They'll work from the shotgun. They'll throw on first down. And down he goes. And the linebacker gets in there for the sack.
Great time to bring some heat to the linebacker spot.
It was a good call defensively. But this offense really needs to do a better job next time of picking up the blitz. I mean, they just got dominated by a freshman.
Second and long coming up here. Ball on the 29-yard line. This defense better be careful. The quarterback is in the zone and really feeling it out there. Airing it out long. He got it. And they tackle him. Northwestern takes a timeout. It's first and 10. Ball on the 32-yard line. Number 14 lines up in the shotgun. Back to pass. He steps up. Pressure coming. They'll make the sack. The linebacker just shot in there and took down the quarterback.
He hardly had time to go through his progression before the fifth-year senior was in his face.
The Wildcats come out in the ace formation. Looking. Wants to throw outside. Got it.
Move those sticks. That's a first down.
And a great catch, too. Did you see how he looked that one in?
Well, there's no doubt about it. He can catch the football.
And we take a quick look at the stats from within the red zone, brought to you by Old Spice Red Zone, when performance matters the most. The offense got six the last time they were inside the 20. Let's see what they do here. Throw short, and it's caught. Fellas, he's really out to an outstanding start in this football game.
Hey, if he continues at this pace, he may throw for 500 yards.
I'll tell you what, this guy is so much fun to watch when he gets into a rhythm like this.
They come out with four wide out. They'll throw again. Defense hasn't stopped them yet. And he lays out and got it for the score. He grabbed that one for his second touchdown of the half.
And that second touchdown pass was just as pretty as the first one. This guy's good.
Hits the PAT. The fine folks at Pontiac bringing us this summary of how that drive took place. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. He boots it deep downfield. Number 24 fields it in the end zone. Jukwu. This defense did a good job on the last series. They forced the offense to go three plays and out.
And now they're looking to build off of that and shut them down again right here.
The Huskies come out in the ace formation. Northern Illinois comes to the line, only one man in the backfield. Huff with the play fake. Across the middle, and he's taken down. That's a gain of eight.
Gain of eight on the play.
Second and two. Ball on their own 29. Some second-half adjustments definitely needed in this one. Our score, Northwestern, 21. Northern Illinois, nothing. Northwestern got the ball to start the game, so they'll be kicking off to start the second half. Kicks it off. Number five fields it in the end zone. Time once again for this offense to come back out and start another drive. They're on the right side of the 50 as they start this drive. From the gun. They'll throw on first down. He's going left. They'll bring him down. Good job on the pass there.
Yeah, let me tell you something. These passes are exactly what they need to put pressure on that defense.
It's second down and two to go. Ball on the 37. Northern Illinois lines up in a shotgun set. Puff hands it off. No, play fake. Throws it to the outside. He's got it on the run.
That was a big-time play and a new set of downs.
I think the defense might have been thinking run there, Coach.
Well, I don't blame them. It's pretty common to see a run on first and second down, but this offense is keeping them guessing.
Have a look at our Old Spice red zone numbers. Red zone. When performance matters the most. Northern Illinois comes to the line with three wide. There's a play fake. Rolls to the left with the throw. Loose football. Number 28 recovers a loose ball. A nice recovery there by the cornerback.
He's used to going after interceptions, but a turnover is a turnover, and he'll take it any way he can get it.
I couldn't agree with you more, Coach.
Thanks, Kirk. That's what I like to hear.
Anytime.
They'll take over at the 7.
They'll start the drive at the 7-yard line. First and 10.
The Wildcats with four receivers. They'll throw on first down. Steps up in the pocket. He wants it all going long. Incomplete. He couldn't make the catch inbound.
You can't fault the receiver. He did all he could to make the catch. The pass was just too far out of play.
Second and 10. Ball on the 7-yard line. The Wildcats come out in the ace formation. Throws to the middle. Finds a man. Brought down.
Way to look it in. Nice catch.
Sure was. He displayed some great hands there. Now we're looking at a first down.
It's first and 10. Ball on the 23. The Wildcats come out in a shotgun. Makes a move. Lost the ball. Fumble. And the defense picks it up. And that fumble recovery may give this defense the spark they needed.
You're right. This could be a huge swing in momentum.
Excellent field position to start the drive. Northern Illinois goes with the ace set here. Puff, little talk to the right. Fumble! Number 20 with a recovery. Nice job there by the defense.
The halfback was unlucky there. He had a good tight grip on the ball. The defender just made a play. One heck of a play.
Yep, what heck of a play indeed.
Get the ball here at the 33.
At the 33-yard line. First and 10.
The Wildcats line up with four wideouts. He's going right. Got it to him on the run. Jed's a tackler, and they make the stop.
I like the defense that was called. They just didn't make the play on the ball.
You're right. It wasn't necessarily bad defense. The offense just executed, and the result was a first down.
First and 10. Ball on the 43-yard line. They'll bring in their dime package. He's looking. Wants to throw outside. It's dropped. Oh, he could have had a big reception that time, guys.
Just let that one get away from his vision just for a split second.
In second down and 10 to go. Ball on the 43. They line up in the shotgun. Drops back to pass. Steps up. Looks. Going deep on the left side.
Boy, Kirk, this defense is in big trouble if they continue to give up touchdowns in the air like that.
Yeah, that's four now that they've given up. Looks like this quarterback has their number today.
And he tacks on the extra point. Time to take a look at the Pontiac drive summary. And remember, the good folks at Pontiac have been bringing you fuel for the soul since 1926. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff.
Number five, back to return.
Kicks it off. Number 24 fields it in the end zone. Tries to juke. We might see two hands on the ball after their last drive.
I mean, if you start thinking too much about fumbling, you become less effective as a runner. They just need to go out there and play their game.
They'll go to work at the 23-yard line. Northern Illinois comes to the line, only one man in the backfield. Punt, with the give. They'll wrestle him down in the backfield. That'll be a 2-yard loss. It's second down and 12 to go. Ball on the 21-yard line. They come out with three wide receivers. They keep it on the ground with a tailback.
Woo-hoo-hoo. He just went right through him.
Who was supposed to block that guy?
I don't think it matters, Kirk. He's playing with reckless abandon out there. It's got to be hard to block a guy that hits like that.
Third down and 12. Ball on the 21. The Huskies come out showing three wide. Back to pass. Looking. Going deep. Lays it out there. And he's got it. And he's tackled. That's how you get a first down, don't you?
They took a risk and went for the long ball. And boy, did it pay off. Excellent play call.
And since we're in the red zone, let's have a look at the numbers. Brought to you by Old Spice Red Zone, when performance matters the most.
Three
Ace backfield. Options out. He lateral. And down he goes. The halfback runs for 4 yards.
Gain of four on the play.
Single set back to you. He drops back. And now he's going to run. And he's taken down. He made a real nice play on that one.
I'll tell you what, in today's game, you have to have the ability to run the football. Give the quarterback a lot of credit. He made a great play and really gave his team a boost.
They line up in the jumbo set. Touchdown, Northern Illinois. The halfback just plowed his way into the end zone.
Yeah, but it wasn't all him. The offensive lineman just pancaked the defense on that one.
He hits the PAT. Time to take a look at the drive summary. It's brought to you by Pontiac, fuel for the soul. Northern Illinois is ready to kick it away. Number 29 and number 26 back to return, and they'll be returning this one. Number 29 fields it at the 3. He jukes. Let's see if this defense has trouble defending the pass again here.
If they do, my friend, look out. They're going to give up another touchdown in a hurry.
They'll set up shot at the 30-yard line. The Wildcats come out in a shotgun. Drops back to pass. He's going right. And they couldn't hook up on that one. He led his wide receiver too far to the outside.
Yeah, he just had to pull the string a little bit more there.
Second and 10. Ball on the 30. Five wide. Little shake and bake move. And they make the stop about 6 yards on the quarterback draw.
Gain of 6 on the play.
It's third down and 4 to go. Ball on their own 36. The Wildcats come out in the ace formation. Gets the ball. No, they faked it. He might not be able to get the pass off. And it's incomplete. He put too much on that throw.
That's his big tight end, and he's definitely not a track star. I think the quarterback just overestimated his speed.
They line up to punt this one away. It's away, and it's a booming punt. Number 5 takes it to 20. Well, the offense is back on the field again. In their last drive, they moved the ball very well, especially through the air on their way to that touchdown. They'll take over at the 23. Huff with 3 wide receivers. He steps up. He's going left. And that one's fallen incomplete, and he overthrew his wide receiver.
I don't know too many 7-foot guys play football, so maybe he should aim lower the next time.
Second and 10. Ball on their own 23. The Huskies with 4 receivers. Huff drops back. Down the middle. It falls incomplete.
Overthrew his man, but boy, did he have some heat on him.
Too much heat. Completing the pass is more important than throwing the ball 100 miles an hour.
That's true. He just needs to put a little bit more touch on that pass.
Look out now. This defensive end is in the zone. Back to pass. Steps up in the pocket. He's looking. Throws it to the outside.
You got to keep it under control. That's some nice arm strength, but it doesn't matter if it's not on target.
You're absolutely right, Coach. You have to be accurate on those type of passes.
Northern Illinois lining up the punt. They get this one off, and it's a beauty. Number 28 takes it at the 32. a very good series for this offense on their last drive as they were forced into a three and out.
Boy, oh boy, they had nothing going last time.
Yeah, maybe, Scooter, you need to get out there and show them what you're made out of.
Somebody get me a helmet quickly.
They'll start this drive at the 39-yard line. They'll bring in their dime package. Steps up, looks, fires deep down the right side, brings it in, touchdown.
You know, I talked about this guy's throwing ability before the game, but nobody really expected these types of numbers. Five touchdowns? That's just amazing.
And he tacks on the extra point. Unless we see some sort of miracle, this one's pretty much over. Heading to the fourth. Our score, Northwestern 35, Northern Illinois 7. Northwestern to kick this one off. Nice kick, plenty of distance. Number 24 fields it in the end zone. This defense did a good job on the last series. They forced the offense to go three plays and out.
And now they're looking to build off of that and shut them down again right here.
They'll get the ball here at the 20. The Huskies come out showing three wide. On the ground with the tailback. A little juke, and he's stopped behind the line. The defense comes up with a good play to pull him down for a loss.
A nice call by the defensive coordinator. It's like he's in their huddle sometimes.
It's second down and 10 to go. Ball on the 20. Northern Illinois comes out in the shotgun. Pump, running the option. He jukes it, and now he pitches it, and there's a fumble. Tackle. They run the option, and it almost cost them.
You can't fumble the football like that. The coach is calling the option because he trusts his players to take care of the football. They're very, very fortunate to get that one back.
They sure are. That one had turnover written all over it.
Third down and four coming up on this one. Ball on their own 26. The Huskies come to the line with their jumbo package. Huff pitches out to the right. And he's tackled. The offense can't get a first, and that'll bring up fourth down.
They need to give their defense more time to rest.
They line up to punt this one away. Punts the ball away. Number 29 takes it to 32. And now we'll see the offense come out onto the field for their next possession. They'll go to work at the 32. The Wildcat set up in the gun. He steps up. Wants to throw outside. Got it to the senior.
Nice decision by the quarterback.
Not only was it good decision-making, but the offensive line protected just long enough for him to find his target.
And when you combine the two, it'll be a first down 9 out of 10 times.
First and 10. Ball on their own 45. Going with the shotgun here. Looking, throws to the middle. And they couldn't hook up on that one. It was a good pass, but the wide receiver couldn't handle it.
Well, the defense here was closing in on him in a hurry, so chances are they would have laid a solid hit on him to cause an incompletion anyway.
So it's second and 10. Ball on the 45. Northwestern lines up in a shotgun set. Drops back to pass. Steps up in the pocket. Throws this one out to the left. What a throw and catch, guys.
I'll tell you what, this young kid has a real gun for an arm. He sizes up the play well, and then gets the ball out of there.
It's third down and a yard for the first down. Ball on the 46. Northwestern will line up in a jumbo set here. They'll go the fullback. Knocked out of bounds. And that'll give him another first down.
Excellent job there, Brad, of running the football. That was good execution by this offense.
First and 10, and this is the fifth play of the current drive. Northwestern lines up in a shotgun set. They keep it on the ground with a tailback. Here's an opening. Oh, what a move. And down he goes. Nice gain for the halfback.
That time they kept it on the ground with the counter play. The blocking was great up front, and the tailback was able to get into the open field and do some special things.
And we take a quick look at the stats from within the red zone, brought to you by Old Spice Red Zone, when performance matters the most. Northwestern comes out in the shotgun. He's going right. Touchdown, Northwestern. That pass found the wide receiver for six.
And I think the quarterback has found a soft spot in this defense.
And he hits the PAT. Here's the drive summary brought to you by Pontiac. Number 93 is lined up to kick this one off. Kicks it off. Number 5 fields it in the end zone. The defense did a nice job of shutting down this offense the last time they had the ball.
The offense was not clicking at all. Let's see if they're back on the same page.
They'll take over at the 20-yard line. They're going to give the backup quarterback some playing time in this blowout. Hit him in the backfield. The quarterback draw not successful there.
Nope, and I'm going to tell you why. This defense was not fooled at all on that play.
Second and long coming up here. Ball on the 12. They come out with three wide receivers. He drops back. He's looking. He rolls out to the right. Lets it go. Caught. Big opening. At the 40. At the 30. To the 20. Goodbye. The wideout makes a big catch there.
Hey, whenever you have a receiver who can make plays like that, you just want to get the ball in his hands and let him do the work.
Listen up, my friend. That was a tremendous throw by the quarterback, too. Don't forget about the guy slinging the ball all over the field out there.
And he tacks on the extra point. And now we're going to take a look at the Pontiac drive summary. Northern Illinois is lining up for the onside kick here. Here it goes. And they'll look to capitalize on the good field position here. Northwestern sets up with four receivers.
Got some open field.
And they make the stop.
And remember one thing that this coach said. They will force it down this defense's throat until they prove that they can stop it.
First and 10. Ball on the 26. The Wildcats line up in a goal line formation. Down 7 yards there. The pressure turns up when in the red zone, and that's when you turn to Old Spice Red Zone, when performance matters the most. Number 18 lines up in the shotgun, and that defense is getting a little excited down there.
Offside.
Well, the offense is helped out by that defensive penalty.
You bet they are. That's an easy way to pick up yards.
He gets 4, maybe 5 yards on the counter. The Wildcats come to the line with their jumbo package. Bring him down. Maybe got 2 feet on the play.
1 yard gain on the play.
Going with the shotgun here. Yards on this one. Northern Illinois calls a timeout. This should be an easy field goal. The kick is up. And it splits the upright. So here's the Pontiac Drive summary to recap what just happened. Northwestern ready to kick this one off. Number 24 and number 5 back ready to return. He kicks it. Number 5 fields it in the end zone. And this one's all wrapped up. Coach, what's your final thought on the game?
I can't say enough about this performance. Northwestern looked like a team on a mission to destroy anything and everything that got in their way. Brad, this is a really good-looking football team.
Folks, it's been a lot of fun, and I hope you can join us again next time. Our final score on this one, Northwestern 45, Northern Illinois 14. This is Brad Nessler for Lee Corso and Kirk Herbstreit saying so long.